as a manufacturing hub, and Cantonese opera was a popular source of family entertainment. Fast forward to the present day, Hong Kong is home to more than 7 million people. Over 90% of our GDP is derived from services, and we are fully plugged into the digital era. This year, we are also celebrating the 20th anniversary of Hong Kong's reunification with China, the most significant transition in our city's history. Guided by the enduring principle of one country, two systems, Hong Kong has emerged as a global business and financial hub. We stand tall alongside Singapore as a leading international city in Asia. Looking ahead, Hong Kong is poised for a new growth spurt. Massive cross-boundary infrastructure projects, including a huge bridge linking Hong Kong with the western part of Guangdong, and an express rail link that will connect Hong Kong with mainland China's high-speed rail network, will be completed within the next 2 years, creating new opportunities for progress. We are also devoting more space and resources for commercial, residential, sports, and cultural development. While embracing change, we also preserve our unique cultural heritage. Amongst other initiatives, a brand new Xichu Center for Chinese Opera will open next year. The Xichu Center will be a key component of a large-scale West Kowloon Cultural District, which is opening in phases to promote various forms of arts and culture. Events such as this exhibition also serve to nurture and preserve our collective memories. Born in Singapore and finding his creative calling in Hong Kong, Mr. Lee, through his life and artwork, echoes the strong bonds between the people of Singapore and Hong Kong. His photos from the 1950s Hong Kong convey the can-do spirit of people of all backgrounds who helped to build our city. The values of hard work, creativity, and determination that we all share. I have the privilege of meeting the late Mr. Lee and reviewing the well-preserved negatives of his high-quality photos. His modesty and positive attitude have left a strong impression on me. I'm sure our friends in Singapore will enjoy this exhibition, and I hope that the images from a bygone era will inspire more people to visit Hong Kong to see firsthand the progress that our city is making. Finally, I want to congratulate our Economic and Trade Office in Singapore and Mr. Edward Stokes of the Photographic Heritage Foundation for staging this exhibition together. It is a fascinating and appropriate event on our program of activities marking Hong Kong's 20th anniversary. I'm confident that the close economic, creative, and cultural bonds between Hong Kong and Singapore will help to foster even stronger friendship and collaboration between our two communities. Thank you very much.